Hello everyone, this is Danny from creatingawebstore.com, and in today's tutorial we're going to talk about mobile websites. This is definitely a topic that we cannot ignore because there are more and more people searching the web through smartphones, iPads, and Android tablets. So we definitely want to accommodate those users by serving up an optimized version of our site specifically for them. But how do we do this? I mean, there are so many different ways to set up a mobile website, and how do we know which route to take? I mean, in the past, I used to actually build separate websites for mobile users. So I would then take that site and I would set it up on a different URL or on a subdomain, and I would try to detect whether my visitors were on a mobile device, and I would redirect them from the desktop version over to the mobile version. Of course, this didn't always work all that well because there are times when you have a hard time detecting whether the person is actually on a mobile device. And while building that mobile site, I would often leave out important information like reviews, and the layout of the site would be much different from the desktop version. And a better way of building a mobile website would be by using responsive web design. And in fact, by using responsive web design, you're actually not building a mobile site at all. All you're doing is you're actually adjusting the layout of your website for mobile users. In fact, even Google recommends responsive web design, and you can read this article if you'd like by visiting my website and creatingwebstore.com. The URL is in the description of this video. And I'm actually going to show you what responsive web design really is. To start, I'm actually going to show you my website, creatingawebstore.com, which actually uses a responsive theme. This right now is the desktop version because I'm on a Safari laptop. And the beauty about responsive web design is that it doesn't actually try to figure out whether your visitor is on a mobile device. Instead, the design adapts to the size of the browser regardless of the user agent. So we're going to adjust the size of this browser so that you can see how it works. See how it adapts to the size? And this is something like what iPhone user, for example, would see. It would be a smaller screen, and the category box actually moved to the bottom. The footer is there, the footer links move to the bottom as well. And on an iPhone, it would pretty much look like this. This is my iPhone emulator right here. See, that's how it would look. Now with sites such as Magento, this is, for example, the desktop version of Magento. And if you try to adjust the browser, you will see that nothing really changes. Instead, they actually serve up a different version of the site for mobile users by detecting the user agent. For example, here on my iPhone emulator, you can see what that mobile version looks like. As you can see, a lot of the information is missing from the home page, and the category layout is somewhat different, and it's really a completely different site on an iPhone. However, the URL does remain the same for both mobile users and desktop users. Of course, there are other sites such as Best Buy, which also have a mobile version, but theirs is on a subdomain, which I will show you in my iPhone emulator here. As you can see, the layout of this site is also different from the desktop version. which is pretty much why I like responsive web design. The design remains the same, the content remains the same, and if in the future you decide to change your theme, as long as you replace it with another responsive theme, you never have to worry about redesigning two sites. You basically redesign one and you're done. The desktop version is displayed on the mobile version, and that's that. Now I'm going to show you a site where I like to get responsive themes. The URL to this website is actually in the description of this YouTube video. And let's go look at some Magento themes. And here we're going to type in responsive. So as you can see, there are quite a few themes here. And this theme actually in particular did very well. 1,110 sales. So it's obvious that people really see the value in these responsive themes. I'm going to actually click it so that you can see what I mean. And here's the live preview. This is a beautiful theme. It really looks amazing. And now when we adjust the browser size, just look at how the theme actually adjusts to it. That is really amazing. Very nice. And now I'm going to copy this URL and paste it into the iPhone emulator here so that we can see what it looks like on the iPhone. That's just really nice, amazing, very, very impressive. So that's that, and stay tuned for more e-commerce related videos.